Welcome.
Thank you.
I feel like I just saw you. Because I did.
Yeah, 2 weeks ago. So good to be in Boston.
Last time Rachel was here, she was doing our morning show, filling in for Ayla Brown. She was with Jackson.
Yep.
So she did a couple of days. How was that?
It was absolutely amazing. So much fun. Every time I'm in Boston, I love it.
So did you tell family that you're going to be on the radio and so they could tune in?
Oh, yeah. They tuned in from Alabama and from Nashville, too. So it was awesome.
That is cool. And then you did something for us down the street, and it was really nice of you to do that. And you performed for everybody, for one of our friends who was there. So we are just feeling like you're family now.
I so feel like Boston is family. I love y'all so much.
So tell us about your experience out there in front of, what, like 8,000 people in the street on stage for a Country 102.5 street party.
Yeah, the first thing that I said on the mic was, wow. And I was just like, I am overwhelmed. Like, it was amazing. I've never played for that many people. My biggest crowd, I feel like, has been like 2,500 or 3,000 at the Opry.
Stop.
And which is amazing, but never a block party. And Boston fans knew the words to my song Damage, and I'm so thankful that y'all just played it and have loved on me so much.
Isn't that cool to have them singing back to you? I mean, that's got to be something.
Yeah, and when I was on tour with Brett Young and we came to Boston, that was the first place that anyone sang back the words, so it was amazing.
And you know what else? Your song came out right around the time last year that the Red Sox were in the playoffs and heading to the World Series, and their motto was Do Damage. So every time that I would play your song, we'd say, yeah, and this one's for the Red Sox, let's do damage.
I love it.
See, hashtag, here you are outside of Fenway Park.
No, that was crazy. It was absolutely crazy.
So fun.
I love that that's the motto.
I know.
Do some damage.
Do damage.
And that's actually where the idea of the song came from. A friend texted me, do some damage. And that's where the whole thing started. So y'all nailed it.
Wow. Well, we just had you as inspiration. That's what it was.
Thanks.
So congratulations on your engagement.
Thank you.
Yeah. Sorry, guys. No, I'm sorry.
Sorry.
She's got a fiance.
Yes.
A fancy.
Yes.
Her fancy.
My fancy.
So tell us about this guy.
Yeah. So Noah's from Montana. We're getting married in like less than 2.5 months. So it is like, it is happening. We're getting married in my hometown. So, you know, Montana and Alabama are like across the country from each other. And we met in Nashville bartending together. Shortly after I met him was after I'd written Damage, actually. So it was pretty crazy how it all like came together. And I never thought that I'd be getting married. I'm the happiest person I've ever been. So
how did he do it?
So he proposed where he asked me to be his girlfriend in Nashville at Centennial Park at the Parthenon. And he like spontaneously asked me to go just couple months ago. And I thought we were just going to like hang or whatever. And then he pulls these like string lights out of his backpack. And he's like, let's string these across the bench. I'm like, this is cute.
Do I know
And I'm
you?
Like, this would be way too obvious. He asked me to be his girlfriend here. And lo and behold, like seconds later, he's down on his knee.
Aww.
And I just like cried for like an hour. And We're so happy. So I wish he could be here. He loves Boston too.
Oh,
so.
Shoot. Next time.
Yes.
I'm sure you'll be back in a couple weeks because that's the way it's going.
Yes, please. I will be back.
Well, we're so happy for all that's going on in your life. And your story, just really quickly, is kind of like a fairy tale. Cause it's not usually how it's done, how you get discovered.
No.
Most people have to pound on doors for many years. But you were in your town.
Yeah.
Doing your gig at your hotel, where you were like
hotels,
a lounge
where everything
singer.
Happens,
right?
For me, yeah. I was discovered in
Muscle
Shoals, Alabama, my hometown. I was a 17-year-old senior in high school, and
That's
at that
crazy.
Point, I'd been writing songs for several years, but I just started playing out. And at the end of my set that I was playing, this guy comes up to me and says, "Hey, my name's Jim Catino. I'm from Sony Music Nashville, and I would love to chat with you about your original songs." And I'm like, this guy's going to kidnap me. This is so not true.
I'm dead.
And
in the back
he
of a
was who he said he was. And we talked about what it would be like to move to Nashville then, maybe pursue that career instead of going to college. But I knew I wanted to get my degree, and I knew that was really important to me. And everybody's path is different, but that's what I needed to do. And so I spent 4 years in college working on my craft, working on my degree, And so, you know, people say Nashville's a 10-year town, but I spent several of my years at home. So, you know.
You worked from home.
Yes, I did. I did. So I'm so thankful for that. I was in my element, and I couldn't be any more blessed to have that opportunity, because a lot of people don't ever get that opportunity in their life.
Exactly.
So I'm so thankful.
So it's Rachel Womack, recording artist and radio personality when she's available.
Yes.
And killing it on stage here for Country 102.5 Street Party. Thank you so much, Rachel. We love having you here.
I love y'all so much.